I am missing you so much. So here we are at home. We are starting our at-home learning, and I have been figuring out all different kinds of ways where we can be creative at home, where we can stay connected at home, and we can still have some fun doing art. So if you're watching this video, you've probably seen the PDF that I sent out. And that PDF, my Google Doc, has three main links on it. The first link is a bunch of art activities. Now, there are all different kinds of things on there. There are options to do art activities at home. There are videos where you can take virtual tours of the museum. There are lots of videos you can watch. So lots of options for you to find things that are going to work for you at home. The second link is the link to this YouTube video. It's Art with Miss Coker, and I'm so excited. I'm going to be posting videos every day of just things that I'm doing at home. Some of the things I'm going to be doing are most likely going to be found on that art activity link. And so you guys can follow along with me or just check in to see what I'm doing. Now, the third link is going to be your artist log. Now, at the end of every week, you're going to need to fill out your artist log, and really you just put your name, you check which homeroom teacher you have, you check your grade level, and let me know that you've been doing some art at home. Now, our goal is to do 10 minutes of art every day. That equals about 50 minutes a week. But you can break it up however you need to do that. And then at the bottom of your artist log, you can type in maybe what your favorite art activity was for the week, or just how you're feeling, or anything like that. So I know, you guys, that not everybody has access to the same supplies. Some people might not have any art supplies at home at all. Even me, a lot of my art supplies are still at school. So we're just going to kind of problem solve, you guys. If you don't have supplies, don't worry. On the first link on that PDF under art activities, there are a ton of stuff for you to choose from. So find something that interests you or find something that works for you, but don't be afraid to challenge yourself too. So let's say at home you don't have a blank piece of paper or a clean piece of paper. Okay, well maybe you have an old coloring book that maybe has a blank page on the back, or maybe you have an old worksheet assignment that you don't need anymore, and maybe that has a blank side on the back. If you don't have a pencil, try using a pen. If you don't have markers, try using crayons, or you know, just whatever can work for you. And it might be fun to do some creative art with any brothers or sisters that you have at home, or any cousins. You can do some stuff with them as well. So I'm excited to get started. We're going to make this work. We're all learning this together, and it's going to be fun. At-home art. So stay tuned. I'm going to post more videos of what I'm doing at home. So hang in there. I'm really excited, and I'll see you soon. Bye.